Okay, so hi Marjuna, how are you?
I'm good.
So how's life going on?
Yes, it's going awesome right
It's
now.
doing awesome. That's great,
Yeah,
fantastic. So Marjuna, I'm Harsh Priyam.
Yeah.
Okay, so I am going to ask you a few questions on behalf of students, which they want to means they have a lot of inquisitiveness कि आखिर मुर्चना दीदी ने इतना सब कैसे किया. So how she actually achieved this much. So you are comfortable in Hindi and English both?
Yes, sir.
Okay, fine. So Murchana, before getting into that session and ये मैं पूछूं पहले कि कैसे किया मुर्चना ने ये सब चीजें, how she got this huge percentage of like 97.4, which is awesome, very awesome. उसके पहले मैं ये जानना चाहूंगा कि मुर्चना, what is the situation around you, your family conditions, your family, who all are there in your family, कौन-कौन है, क्या-क्या करते हैं, पापा क्या करते हैं, and situation around you. If you can put some light on that.
Okay, so myself, Murchana Pathak, I hail from the northeastern state of Assam. I reside in a small town named Abhayapuri. In my family, I have my parents, my younger sister, and my paternal grandmother. Both my parents are government school teachers, so I
Okay,
get a lot of study vibes from them.
that's great. That's great, Murchana. Fine. So, Murchana, okay. So you said that you hail from northeast eastern state, and if I'm not wrong, it's not even Assam. So it's somewhere interior to that.
Yeah, so it's interior, like about 200 kilometers from the state capital.
200 kilometers from state capital.
Yeah,
So.
sir.
Okay, I'm assuming that okay, so it's not some very prominent city of Assam.
It's not even a city, actually. It's a town.
Okay, it's not even a city, it's a town. Wow, that's
Yeah,
great. So
yeah.
this means I have started getting goosebumps that okay, wow, you have done such a tremendous work of 97.4% without even getting a city like facilities, probably in a village kind of place. That is more than awesome, yeah. Okay, so Murchana, yeah, please go ahead.
It's not a village, like, but it's not that urban also. I just
Okay, so
wanted to
it's
clarify.
kind of semi-urban, you can say that.
Yes, semi-urban.
Okay, fine. So Murchana, then I am very much interested in knowing your entire journey, how it all started. First of all, how did you get that? Okay, you have to do something extra, you have to study hard, and you have to achieve something extra, and after that. I just want I have to just I just wanted to know is like कि कैसे इतने छोटे से जगह में means which is like not such a big education hub but still you managed to get so many things and you did so wonderful things. How was it?
Okay, so sir, like I have been good in academics since my earlier classes. So my father used to tell me that life is like a competition, and if you don't held an upper place, then you might lose it. So I always had the thing that yeah, I have to do it. Like,
Okay.
okay. And then when I entered high school, things were pretty difficult for me initially, because like there's a big transition from class 8 to class 9. Oh, like basically children faced issues and I too faced them. But then, I had the destiny that yeah, I have to do this because it's like do or die. It was something like that. And my father, basically, he has always motivated me to do things out of the box. Like he managed to get me a computer way back in 2011, like going to a place we live in. We had a computer back in 2011. And so I got pretty used to all such technical things and all. So it was he who like got me in Vedantu. Like it was because of him that I'm in Vedantu today. So I owe
Okay.
a lot of him because
Okay,
of my
fine. So it looks like that your father is a tech savvy guy, and probably he likes trying new technologies.
Yeah,
Okay. So
definitely.
then I would come to on this point that how did Vedantu made a difference in means your life and how Vedantu is a reason in shaping up to your current situation.
Okay, so back in class 9, the place I live in, my knowledge was quite restricted to my school textbooks. Like, we were not taught anything other than a school textbook. But once I got into Vedantu, things quite changed. Like, I got exposure to many new things. Animated slides, high, like you know, life classes, quizzes, tests, everything was very new. So I got a bit more competitive after entering Vedant Bookers. Like, I've met kids from entire India and I got to know what kids are doing all over India. And all those experiences, like Vedantu's concepts, once I enrolled in Vedantu, my concepts were pretty much clearer. So I feel that Vedantu is creditable for my achievement today.
That's great. That's great. Fantastic. I really love to hear that. Okay. So, Murshina, I would then like to ask you that, okay, so you were living at that place, and what were other challenges which you used to face while you were living at that place? So, can I get the city name? Sorry, I missed that. Very sorry for that.
Abhayapuri.
Abhayapuri.
Yeah.
Okay. So, what were the challenges which you were facing, especially in that place, Abhayapuri, which you would have thought ki probably if I would have in Delhi or Bangalore, things would have been much more better compared to here. So, what were those challenges?
So, here we have quite most of the resources. Like, students do have good results right here. But, you know, in places like city, metro cities like Delhi, Bangalore, as you mentioned, they have a good teaching faculty, I must say, like the coaching thing and all. Here we do have teaching teachers, but they, you know, students go to tuition in batches, 15 to 20 students in one batch. The teacher keeps teaching, rather, like, he doesn't care whether the student's doubt is cleared or not. But in other places, like, I can see that in coaching institutes, every child is, like, you know, given importance. So I faced that, and here, basically, my school was the only CBSE school, unfortunately.
Okay.
So, like, the all the other schools were of the, like, state board, and I wanted to pass my classes in CBSE too. I had to go to that school, and that school is, like, again, somewhere in a kind of a remote area. But still, I managed that. The last 10 years of my life, I must say that even if I have not got much resources compared to others, but I have quite utilized the amount of resources I have got.
Okay, so means the amount, it's not the amount of resources which matter. So this one thing which I'm able to get, it's not the amount of resources which you have. Rather, the most important part is that how do you utilize the available resources around you? So probably you have played on that thing pretty well, that you have tried to manage those, means you have tried to utilize those resources pretty well. Okay, cool. So this means that, in fact, this is a message to all the students as well, to out there, those who are living in some remote areas. You should not think that you are not living in some of the metro city of the country. Rather, like just Murshina, what she is saying, you can very well assume that, okay, whatever resources you have, in that resource also, you can do pretty well. Okay, so that's really great. Fantastic to know that, Murshina. And I'm very much amazed to know, because if I do remember you, Murshina, from my batches as well. So I guess you were there in my batch. Okay.
Yeah, class 10, Akar 10A.
Akar 10A. Yeah, I do remember you. So I still remember that Murshina was never of this attitude that, okay, sir, I'm having a lot of problem. I have this problem. I have that problem. I don't understand things or whatever. In fact, I was never knowing that she is coming from such a remote area. Today, when she is in front of me, I'm actually able to know that, okay, she has a lot of challenges which she actually overcome. And to be very true in words, I would say that she never felt those challenges, isn't it? Yeah. Because probably she always thought that, okay, whatever I have to just do in this much only. And I don't have to complain about the situation. Rather, I have to come above it and I have to prove myself. And here she is having 97.4%. It's like awesome thing. Okay. So, Murshina, now I would be asking you one more thing. Your face looks pretty happy. Okay, yes, 97.4%. That's great. So I still remember my students saying me that, sir, I want to meet you or I want to have a one-to-one interaction with you. And I used to say, okay, marks achhe le aao, thereafter I'll be meeting you. So yes, Murshina, you owe me. Obviously, I'll be sending some goodies to you from my side.
Thank you, sir.
I wanted to ask a few more things. That, okay, many a time students do think the topper students, that those who get very good marks, they are pretty much focused students. They don't get any problem. They don't get demotivated. They won't you don't get demoralized. So what was the situation on your side? Do you also, means, do you think that upper students are like that, or which type of student are you? Do you also get demoralized or demotivated sometimes, or you are like 100% charged up every time? How is it like on your side?
Okay, so like, yeah, I know that toppers are always given the tag that they are very much super motivated. They're kind of introverts, confined to books. They don't talk to anyone, but it's definitely not me. Okay, so yeah, there were times when I was demotivated. Of course, you can't study all the time. You do like get bored sometimes. But in my case, it was not to that extent that I wanted to leave studying. So my parents always motivated me to study because, you know, the place where I come from, you know, people always expect a lot from you. In my case, it was such case. And so I knew that if I get demotivated, things are not going to work. So, yeah, like my parents motivated me then to chill out sometimes. Like I used to play with my sister. Then we have got a pet dog at my home. So just spending time with animals also gives you like a lot of happiness sometimes, because like I used to take him for walks and play with him. It's all very like soothing. And so there was no kind of demotivation all the time. But yeah, like once during my first pre-board, I was demotivated a lot because like I had got really less marks in maths especially. And like perhaps maths happens to be my favorite subject and I had scored the least in maths. So I felt like, what am I gonna do in boards?
Okay.
But then, my parents again told me that study, no problem, it's just a pre-board, you will definitely do well in boards. And then I too thought that like, let's give it another try. And then like the results were pretty amazing, like I scored 100 in maths and I was like very happy about it.
that's great. I'm also more than double happy that my students are scoring 100 out of 100, and so many students that too. That's really great, Marchana.
Yes, Fine. I owe it to you too.
Pardon?
I owed 100 to you too. Like, for being
that's great. Thanks a lot. Fine. So, Marchana, since you were there in one of my long-term batches, I taught you the entire year. So, what do you think that means? What would have been the situation if Vedantu would have not been there? So, say, for example, if I would not have taught you, probably you would not have gone to Vedantu, some local coaching institutes. So what do you think, what difference would have been there, or what benefit you got in Vedantu?
So basically, yeah, if Vedantu had not been there, then I would have like joined the local tuition class. Yeah, but they use a policy that the thing is to cover the concepts, finish the book exercises, and that's it.
Mm-hmm.
But Vedantu went ahead of it. We had a lot of quizzes, a lot of concept clearing sessions. Then the most exciting thing I found is that you had monthly tests. So if that monthly test would have not been there, then I would not know where do I stand, basically.
Mm.
So that test really helped me to figure out that whether this concept is clear for me or not. If Vedantu would have been not there, then yeah, I would study, I would see YouTube, I would go to tuition teachers, but my concepts would have not been that clear and I might not have scored that high, like 97. Okay. I would have scored 90 plus, but not 97.4, I guess.
Okay, that's great, fantastic. Okay, so and apart from that, so Murchana, what about your school or your friends? How did they score? Or was there anyone from your school or friend circle who was also in Vedantu? Do you know any one of them?
So like at the time when I joined Vedantu, there was no one because online tuition classes were not considered to be like, you know, yeah, like why are you taking such things? We were going to go against it. Okay, so
yeah.
I had joined Vedantu at a risk, basically.
Okay.
Class 10. But in class 10, I was completely alone. But once my results were out, when people saw that, yeah, Vedantu also like has so many good results, people around me started taking Vedantu. Like, yeah, a few of my friends are in Vedantu right now. They have enrolled in JEE and NEET courses.
Mm-hmm.
And like few of our family friends have also joined Vedantu, like their kids in lower classes.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Okay. So at that time when you had joined, they had not engaged into Vedantu platform. Fine. So it was a kind of risk taken by you. and eventually it came out to be a good worthwhile taking risk, isn't it? Chalo, that's great. So in fact, I'm able to say that many students in last few years, all those students whom we have interviewed, most of them have taken this decision out of fear, means out of what you can say risk kind of thing, that whether should I take it or not, and eventually it came out to be very good for them, that they got to know, okay, wow, this was a very good decision and I'm happy for that. Fine. So Murshana, now if I ask you, so can you just share a little about your daily routine which you used to follow, including the school timings and thereafter Vedantu timings, and how you used to manage them, what was good, what was bad in that?
Okay, so initially when my class 10 started, my school was from like 8 to 3. Mm-hmm. So I used to get up in the morning, read for an hour or two, then get ready for school. Then about 7 hours I used to spend in the school. Then coming home, mostly like many of my companions, they used to take rest. But I, on the other hand, I used to read in the afternoon.
Okay, like that's great.
Okay, it's more like not everyone does so, but I used to read in the afternoon. Then like evening, 1 hour or so, I used to take a break. Then I had Vedantu classes from 7 o'clock. From 7 to 8:30, I was here. Then 8:30 to 9:30, I was into watching TV, having my dinner and so. Then after that, I used to read till 11. So that was my daily routine.
Okay, fine. So every day, 1.5 or 2 hours of Vedantu session. And before that, you used to study of your own. And after that, you used to do some enjoyment like kind of a TV or talking with friends or spending time with the family. Cool. So yeah. Just one more thing. I got to know for my students that toppers do not always study. So they also have that family time and enjoyment time. So probably, in fact, every day. Some of the students, they ask me that, sir, okay, toppers might be going out for a break only on Sunday. So I do tell them that, no, it's not only Sunday. Every day they do some masti. So you have to just understand that. Chalo,
yeah,
that's
sir, I yeah, that I was the head girl of my school. So whenever the school had any functions, so most of the responsibilities were on my head. So like owing to that also, I had to cut some of my study hours because of that.
Okay, fine. I got it. So this means that it's not only study. In fact, you have to be a social being as well. Probably, so Murshana, correct me if I am wrong, what do you think? Somewhere being the social element and engaging yourself into social activities like one which you said that being the head girl of the school and then managing things on that front as well, which sometimes costed you on the study part. So what do you think? These social engagements were they helpful in cutting down your stress part? Were they helpful in, adding some spice to your life? Did you feel that?
Yeah, because they are really kind of a stress busters, because like people think that getting into all such things is gonna ruin your studies. But that's not the thing. Once you know to manage your time between your studies and your other interests, then definitely no one can harm your studies. So me engaging in all those activities was very kind of like stress buster for me, because I used to like all that, like, you know, managing things, organizing, then leadership and all, like giving. I have good speaking skills, so I used to speak a lot at school. So yeah, all those things really helped me develop from all the perspectives, not only academic wise but also like co-curricularly.
That's really great. Fantastic, Murshana. So in fact, again, a knowledge booster for all students watching out there, that being a social being is a better thing, not a bad thing. In fact, you should be a social being. It will help you guys in busting your stress level, and apart from that, it will also help you to come up with new ideas so that you can implement them in your studies. Cool. So Murshana, next, if I ask you about your studying pattern, so what used to be your studying pattern? Was it like that? First of all, I would like to know that, were you a morning person or a evening, means night person? So were you? Yeah, go ahead.
I'm not a night owl, definitely. I can't like stay awake after 11:30, even now.
Okay, that's great.
So I'm basically a morning person, like waking up at 5:30 or 6. Like not now, but during those exam days.
Okay, fine. So you are a morning person. Now thereafter, So what used to be your study pattern? Was it like that studying whenever you want or whenever you feel like, or studying every day at a kind of for a fixed number of hours or for at a fixed time? Was it how was it like?
No, I had fixed hours for studying since childhood. I had been made this timetable by my parents that you must have fixed hours for studying and fixed hours for refreshment, so that you are able to manage things, your studies as well as your interest. So basically, I used to have a timetable in class 10, although I had changed it many a times. But yeah, like fixed hours in the morning for studying, after coming from school, like studying for 1 hour, one half an hour, and taking a rest, and we run to classes again, like some refreshing activities, and then study. Yeah. So I had fixed times basically, but sometimes I had to alternate them for other purposes.
Okay, fine, that's good. And so if I ask you that, were you used to sit for hours and hours, or was it like taking breaks between intervals, like 30 minutes or 1 hour? After that, you used to take break. So how it used to be like?
Okay, so I used to have breaks during my study timetable because I cannot sit for long hours, like 3-4 hours. I somehow managed it for Vedant too, but other than that self-studying part, I used to take a lot of breaks frequently after 45 minutes or 1 hour. Yeah.
That's great. That's great. Fantastic. Okay, so Murchana, on that part, so I wanted to ask this much. So is there any message which you would like to give to all your fellow mates or all your juniors, anything whichever you want?
Okay, so I want to tell is that mostly the students who are in 10th or who are giving the board exams, that during the exam preparation, don't try to try to avoid all the negative thoughts in your mind. So like the thing is, while preparing for exams, students have a lot of stress on their head, be it family pressure, be it peer pressure, then the society expects a lot from you, then you have this concern like in you that what if I don't stand up to everyone's expectation. So all these things like create a lot of stress. Like in my case, it did not, because I did not take, but many students go through this. So like just try to avoid all those negative thoughts, like, because if you take all such kind of stress, you will be you are going to panic during the preparation, and you won't be able to revise things.
Okay, that's great, Murchana. So Murchana, before closing, I would really like to have some kind of rapid fire quizzes with you, like we used to have in our session.
Okay.
So tell me, like, whom do you love most?
Like my mom.
Okay, so your mom. So no, you have to just give me that answer which instantly comes in your mind. You don't have to think on that. Whatever name first comes in your mind, you have to just say that. Okay. Which is your best food? Favorite food?
Butter chicken.
Okay, yeah. Butter chicken. That's great. Your dream place which you want to visit?
Maybe or something related to trekking and all.
Who is your role model?
So I don't have a role model basically. So I just I just take inspiration from people who work hard and, like, you know, they start from scratch and achieve a lot in their life.
Okay, that's great. Fine. What is your dream job?
To join the medical line.
Okay, so you want to be a doctor?
Yeah,
that's fantastic. Okay, thereafter, if I want to ask you, so after your 12th, which stream you wanna go? Means I guess that is bio, isn't it?
Yeah, bio.
Okay, fine. Cool. And if you would like to name some 3 teachers in your life, entire life, so who would be them?
Okay, so it would be you. buttering. Genuinely, okay. Like, you have been my teachers, that's why.
Okay.
You, then Vani ma'am.
Okay.
And the third one would be my school teacher, like my class teacher, Miss Pinky.
Okay, Miss Pinky, that's great, fantastic. Cool. So Murchana, that it was really very insightful talking to you, and I am very much happy, because, and not only from one fact that you scored so well, I'm in fact happy that a girl or a student from such a remote part of country is actually able to access a quality education, and that too from metro city, without she being displaced to any other place, without you going to any other place and being in the comfort of your own house, being in the secured environment of your parents, they giving you the motivation, and you were able to get that quality education. So I'm really happy to that, happy to see that. And apart from that, I'm in fact happy to see that that quality education is making a difference. Students are getting that good and beautiful marks. You are looking so confident, you're looking so happy, and you are now very much confident that your dream and your destination is not far away, despite whatever be your location, whatever be your environment around you. But you are looking very much confident, to me at least, that yes, you will surely hit your target. So I wish you all the best in your life, Murjana. Go ahead and achieve your dream. And whenever you need us, surely we are there for you. Okay? Thanks a lot, Murjana. It was really nice talking to you. Thank you. Bye-bye.
Bye, sir.
Bye-bye.